Welcome back to the next session of Microbes in Human Welfare. Now in this session we are looking at the next part of microbes. Now in the previous session we have already saw the role of microbes in sewage treatment plants, the role of microbes in production of the biogas, and role of microbes in the industrial field, role of microbes in the household food products. And next part that we are going to study today is microbes as biocontrol agents. Now let's go to the title called as microbes as biocontrol agents. This is nothing but the role of microbes as a biocontrol agents of pest. With the use of microbes or with the use of certain insects, how can we protect, preserve our crop plants from the predators like other insects or other microbes? This is like kill a harmful microbe or a pathogen through the same biological agents. Okay, idu yav reethi antandra mullannu mullinindana tagidu anta one the harmful insect na innond useful insect indana kill madodu, so that our crop plant has to be preserved, protected. Okay, then in the earlier days what was done was the use of insecticides, pesticides, we used to do this to kill the pathogens so that we can protect our agricultural crops. But by this what will happen? One thing, it leads to chemical pollution, insecticidal pollution, and on the other hand the aerosols will cause respiratory disease to the humans. This is one harmful effect of that. Then apart from that, the farmer has to purchase these insecticides from the APMC yards. That means that the cost is also more. Then these chemical pesticides or insecticides do not differentiate our agricultural crops or the pest or sometimes even the herbicides also. Okay, that means the chemicals may damage even our crop plants sometimes. As a result, instead of using this chemical fertilizer, chemical insecticides, why can't we implement a technique in such a way that by the use of the natural microorganisms or natural insects, we can kill these harmful pathogens. The same technique has been implemented, and we have taken it under the heading called as microbes as biocontrol agents. Mainly they are microbes, the role of the microbes which acts like the biocontrol agents of pest. Now let us make the list of all these things. Now out of this, let me take into in the form of the points. Let me go to the first point. The first point is ladybird beetle, which is a insect. Ladybird beetle. Now this ladybird beetle is a insect which kills the population of aphids. It controls the population of aphids. Aphids are smaller insects. They are small insects which will injure the leaf. When they injure the leaf, ultimately the process of photosynthesis is reduced in the crop plants, and hence the yield is also reduced. That means with these insects, aphids are going to damage our crop plants, and we have to prevent this. Our old technology was we were spraying insecticides on the crop plants to kill the aphids, but nowadays we are using ladybird beetle. Ladybird beetle, usually it is a black colored insect on which red color spots are there. Okay, beetle, it is an insect. Adakku now borangi reethi iruvantada adu. It is a black with a red color spots on its body. Body malagade red color spots kaanista irutav. That is ladybird beetle, which feeds, which eats on the aphids, and it controls the population of the aphids. As a result, we are going to protect our crop plants. This is one thing. Then second one is a dragonfly. Now dragonfly, they are also arthropoda insects. They will fly. Usually you call them as helicopter. Ekandra nodlike adha reethi kanista irthava. That's why they are also called as helicopter flies. Its name is a dragonfly. Now this dragonfly, it controls the population of mosquitoes. So it controls mosquitoes. The population of mosquitoes. That means mosquitoes will lay the eggs in the aquatic resources. It might be a pond, it might be a river, wherever, especially mainly the stagnant water. When they lay the egg, eggs will hatch into larvae. The larvae will be swimming in the water. Later on, they undergo metamorphosis, becomes adult, and they will fly away, these mosquitoes. The role of the dragonfly is, it invades the aquatic water bodies like ponds, streams, wells, and if the mosquito larvae are there, the dragonfly will eat these mosquitoes. It will eat these mosquitoes, thereby controlling its population. Okay. Now, what is the harmful effect of the mosquitoes? Usually, mosquitoes, male mosquitoes, will be sucking the sap of the plant. Sap means it is the food or the juice which is produced by the plant through the stem, through its proboscis, it will be sucking the fluid. As a result, it will lower the crop yield to a little extent. But still, we are using these dragonflies to control the population of mosquitoes. Okay, this is the second biocontrol agent. Then the third biocontrol agent is Bacillus thuringiensis. We also call it as a BT. Bacillus thuringiensis is the name of the bacteria. In short, we call it as BT bacteria. Now, we are taking this BT bacteria, then this BT bacteria is packed in the form of sachets, like the shampoo sachets. It is packed in the form of sachets in which many BT spores will be there. We cut the sachet, we pour it, we mix it with water, then we properly mix it, and then this is sprayed to certain plants. It is sprayed to certain plants. Now what it will do? Okay, what it will do? Now this will, it controls the butterfly caterpillar. It controls the population of butterfly caterpillars, where the caterpillar is the larval stage. That larva will be feeding on the leaves of the crop plants, hence damaging it. Hence Bacillus thuringiensis, BT, they are available in the form of spores packed in the sachets. It is mixed with the water and it is sprayed on the plants. Then on which plants it is sprayed? Mainly this BT, it is sprayed on the plants like the fruit trees and brassicas. Okay, it is sprayed on the vulnerable plants like the fruit trees and brassicas. Brassicas, ಬ್ರಾಸಿಕೇಶಿಯಾ, ಇಟ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಮಸ್ಟರ್ಡ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ, ಸಾಸಿವೆ ಗಿಡ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ನಾವು, ಆ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿಗೆ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ ಆಗುವಂಥದ್ದು. ನಾವು ವೆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಿ ಟಿ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಪ್ರೇಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡೂ, ಆ್ಯಸ್ ದ ಬಟರ್ಫ್ಲೈ ಕ್ಯಾಟರ್ಪಿಲ್ಲರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಫೀಡಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಲೀವ್ಸ್, ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಫೀಡಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಲೀವ್ಸ್ ದ ಬಿ ಟಿ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಎಂಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಗಟ್. ಗಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಇಂಟೆಸ್ಟೈನ್. ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಇಂಟೆಸ್ಟೈನ್ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ರಿಲೀಸಸ್ ಟಾಕ್ಸಿಕ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಾನ್ಸಸ್ ಬೈ ವಿಚ್ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪರ್ಫೋರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಇಂಟೆಸ್ಟೈನ್. ಪರ್ಫೋರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಎಸ್ ಹೋಲ್ಸ್, ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಹೋಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಇಂಟೆಸ್ಟೈನ್, ದೇರ್ ಬೈ ಕಿಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಟರ್ಪಿಲ್ಲರ್. ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಬಿ ಟಿ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಟರ್ಪಿಲ್ಲರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಟರ್ಫ್ಲೈ, ವೇರ್ ದ ದೀಸ್ ಬಟರ್ಫ್ಲೈ ಕ್ಯಾಟರ್ಪಿಲ್ಲರ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡ್ಯಾಮೇಜಿಂಗ್ ಅವರ್ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಮೇನ್ ರೀಸನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಅ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಒನ್. ದೆನ್ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ರೈಕೋಡರ್ಮ. ನಾವು ದಿಸ್ ಟ್ರೈಕೋಡರ್ಮ ಇಟ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ಸ್ ಸವರಲ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಪ್ಯಾಥೋಜನ್ಸ್. Trichoderma is a fungus which is available in the form of powder, and this powder is spread to the roots of the plants, and in the roots of the plants there will be most of the microorganisms that will be damaging the roots, that will be damaging the roots of the crop plants, and hence this Trichoderma, a fungus, it is going to control several plant pathogens that are going to infect the roots, thereby preventing the infection and thereby healthier growth of the plants where the yield can be increased. So this is the role of Trichoderma. Trichoderma is a fungus which controls many plant pathogens which are present in the roots of the plants. Okay, because as the plants will be growing in the soil, lot of pathogens will be there in the soil. Those pathogens should not destroy our crop plants, otherwise the yield gets decreased. Okay, the next one, Baculovirus. Baculovirus, it belongs to the genus Nucleopolyhedrovirus. Baculovirus is a virus only. It belongs to genus Nucleopolyhedrovirus. Now what it will do, what is its role? Now it controls arthropoda pests. Mainly they belong to arthropoda pest, and this is used as baculovirus. It is used as species specific, narrow spectrum, insecticidal, applications. Now look at the term that we are going to use here. Baculovirus, it belongs to the genus Nucleopolyhedrovirus. It controls mainly arthropoda pests. It is used as species specific narrow spectrum insecticidal applications. The meaning of this is species specific. This baculovirus is going to target a single species which is damaging our crop plants, and by which these pathogens are killed and the crop is healthier. Okay, so it gets rid of the infection. Now this is regarding the list of the microbes as biocontrol agents of pest, and all together it comes under a management, a program called as a IPM. All this comes under IPM. which designates integrated pest management. Integrated pest management altogether comes under a broader heading called as IPM, integrated pest management. That means how the pest has to be managed, how these pest that destroys our crop plants can be controlled with the knowledge of our environment and the organisms present in it. That means in the microbes as biocontrol agents, we are controlling, that means we are controlling the pathogens with the available microbes that are present in the nature. Okay. Now, because of these things only, apart from these, there are lot many species. Now, for example, there is a saying that we should not kill cobras, snakes. What is the reason? This is because they are the holy animals, they are the worshipped animals. Not only this reason, the major reason behind this is we have to conserve that species because this snake will feed on those insects that is going to destroy our crop plants. Understood? That means when it eats these insects do not destroy our plants. Our agricultural crops will grow well. Hence, most of the species which are present in the nature, they have their self role in regulating different organisms. Most of the organisms naturally control other pests that will destroy our crop plants. Hence, each and every species that are present in this nature has to be conserved as well as preserved, because they also play an important role in ecological balance, balance of the nature. Okay. So, this is regarding the microbes as biocontrol agents. Now, in this, these major 5 points are most important, because out of this anyone can be asked for an objective, or this can be asked for a short notes type of question, okay, for a 3 mark level. Okay. So, this is regarding the microbes as biocontrol agents of pest. Then with this, let us move on to the next heading. Microbes as biofertilizers. Okay, now here microbes as biofertilizers. How the microbes which are present in the nature can be used as biofertilizers? Okay, the best example for this, I'll tell you. Which animal is called as a friend of a farmer? Raithara gelaya antu karithivi. Which organism is called as friend of a farmer? Yes, it is the earthworm. Why earthworm is called as friend of a farmer? Because this is going to increase the fertility of the soil. It is going to increase the fertility of the soil. Then how it increases the fertility of the soil? Because it feeds on the soil particles, then its compost, where we call it as vermicompost, that is released into the soil, it will increase the fertilizer quality, fertility part of the soil. As a result, earthworms are regarded as friend of the farmer. Then, apart from these earthworms, earthworm is one of the best classical example. From which we are going to get vermicompost. Idhik nav erehula gobbara antu karithivi, vermicompost. There are other microorganisms which are present in the roots of legume plants. What are those? Yes, we have rhizobium. Rhizobium is the bacteria which is present in roots of legume plants. Then what does it do? This helps in fixation of atmospheric nitrogen. It fixes atmospheric nitrogen in the form of ammonia, whereby increasing the nitrogen content in the soil. Rhizobium is a bacteria which is present in symbiotic relation with the roots of which plants? Legume plants. Okay, this is one thing. Then apart from this, other free living bacteria are also there, where we call them as a Azospirillum. And Astrobacter, they are free living bacteria. Then what is their role? Their role is same, again fixation of atmospheric nitrogen to the other plants. They are also free living bacteria. Rhizobium is symbiotic and Azospirillum as well as Astrobacter, these are non-symbiotic which are present in the soil. They also help in fixation of atmospheric nitrogen. Okay. Then let us take one more example called as Mycorrhiza. Okay, one more example is Mycorrhiza. Now what is Mycorrhiza? Mycorrhiza is a fungus which belongs to genus Glomus. It is a fungus that belongs to genus Glomus. Okay, remember this, it will be asked for an objective question. To which genus Mycorrhiza belongs to? It is Glomus. Now Mycorrhiza is present in association with roots of higher plants, mainly the gymnosperms. Okay, mainly the gymnosperms. Now what it is going to do? It is going to provide nutrition, nourishment, mainly minerals. So it provides minerals like phosphorus. To roots of the plants. Then as it is going to give phosphorus to the roots of the plants, NPK, nitrogen, potassium, phosphorus, all these are major required nutrients for the growth of the plants. Mycorrhiza is a fungus which is present in association of the roots of the higher plants, mainly the gymnosperms, and it is going to provide phosphorus minerals to the roots. Then apart from this, it also provides moisture along with the water to some extent. Then other role is also there. It also helps in it also controls pathogens. Then apart from this, it also helps in stress conditions. Like drought, salinity, etc. Okay. Then it helps in growth of the plants. It helps in growth of the plants. Now this is the beneficial role of the fungus, and that fungus is Mycorrhiza. Mycorrhiza not only provides phosphorus to the roots of the plants, but in turn it controls various different types of pathogens that will infect the roots of the plants, then it also helps to overcome the abiotic stresses like a drought. If there is no rainfall, it does not allow the plant to die. Then salinity, if there are excess salts, these excess salts should not damage the roots. So it also prevents against drought and salinity. It also helps in the normal and proper growth of the plant. So this is the beneficial role of mycorrhiza, where we call them as microbes as biofertilizers. Ultimately, they are going to increase the fertility of the soil. Okay. Then with this, there are other cyanobacteria. Like Nostoc, Anabina, Oscillatoria, which are present in paddy fields. They are present in the roots of the paddy fields, and what they will do? They will increase or they will fix fixation of atmospheric nitrogen. That means the atmospheric nitrogen is fixed by this cyanobacteria like Nostoc, Anabina, Oscillatoria. They are present in paddy fields. They will increase even the fertility of the soil by fixation of atmospheric nitrogen. Okay. So these are various different types of cyanobacteria that are involved in increasing the fertility of the soil. Now, when the fertility of the soil is increased by the naturally occurring microorganisms, ultimately it is going to increase the yield of our crop plants. That means productivity can be increased with the help of the microorganisms, and hence these microorganisms are said to be, or it acts like biofertilizers. Okay. Then apart from this, one additional is, in the mycorrhiza there are two types, endomycorrhiza as well as ectomycorrhiza. We just divided it into two types. So this mycorrhiza is of two types. Endomycorrhiza and ectomycorrhiza. Endomycorrhiza means the fungal hyphae enters inside the roots of the plants. Endo means inside, ecto means outside. As you know, endoparasites, for example, Ascaris, if it is present inside our intestine, it is called as an endoparasite. Leech is an ectoparasite. Leech jiganenten karitivi, it is a blood sucking, it will be present on the body of the host. If an organism is present on the body, we call it as ecto. If it is present inside, we call it as endo. Now mycorrhiza is a fungus. Suppose if this fungal hyphae are inserted inside the root olagade enter agiddu antadra, such type of mycorrhiza are said to be endomycorrhiza. Now they appear like a tube, yukna vesicles and karitivi, bulge agirtav, arbuscular and karitivi, and these are mycorrhiza. That's why this endomycorrhiza, they are commonly called as a VAM. They are commonly called as a VAM. VAM refers to vesicular arbuscular mycorrhiza. These are said to be vesicular arbuscular mycorrhiza. Which one? Endomycorrhiza. Ectomycorrhiza, as the name says, they are present on the root surface. They are not inserted, its fungal hyphae is not inserted inside the root, but it is present on the root. And these they are thread like, hyphae are thread like, which measures around several meters. And from that other distance, it will provide the nutrients, the elements like phosphorus. Along with that, even it also helps to drag the moisture to the roots of the plants, where the plants can grow well and they can survive well. Okay. So this is regarding the beneficial role of the microbes, and where we give the title as microbes as biofertilizers. Okay. So this is the beneficial role of the microbes in human welfare, where different types of microbes play an important role and they help the human in day to day life. Okay. So with this we'll end up the chapter today, and we'll start with a new topic in the coming class. Have a nice day. Thank you.